Passionate.
Cheeky.
Inspirational.
An achiever.
Caring.
Always forward-looking.
Knowledgeable.
Selfless.
Positive.
Warm.
The leading statesman of British agriculture.
And extremely honest.
Just Henry Plum. The story starts really with Henry being taken out of that classroom at the age of 15. Henry talks with great enthusiasm how he threw the satchel down, thinking that this was a great wheeze to get off school for a few weeks, not realizing at that moment in time the severity or the length of the war that would take him to start building that early career on the farm. It didn't take long before Henry's passion for farming, his interest in the wider industry as a whole, elevated him through the NFU ranks within the county of Warwickshire. Henry to this day remains a very proud member and participant in Warwickshire NFU. He spent 4 years as vice president, 2 years as deputy president, and absolutely no surprise to anybody that he then served a staggering 9 years as president of the NFU. And I have a vivid memory of Henry being championed through the streets of Westminster, carried high on the shoulders of farmers. Henry does go down, without any shadow of a doubt, as the greatest president of the NFU it has ever had.
Now, I had a fascinating period in office because of the change, moving away from the price review system to the Common Agricultural Policy.
Sir Henry, as the NFU's president during the whole period of our joining the common market, would you say that that was a fair analysis of the situation?
No, quite the reverse is the case. We've been involved in international affairs for a very long time, so we didn't suddenly wake up one morning and think, now we've joined a European Economic Community, the situation changes. In fact, of course, it's doubled up our operation to a great extent.
Lord Plum was the person that I turned to for advice and support, and he has mentored, helped, advised me along my sort of agricultural political career, and I'm very grateful for that.
The challenge was then, where does he go next? What does he do? He then went on to be elected as the first and only British person to be the leader of the European Parliament. It's a beautiful day. Don't let it get away. On stepping down from the European Parliament, Henry took up his seat in the House of Lords.
The most important thing that Henry's done is brought an everyday approach to farming and food production to a parliament that has people on our benches, many of whom have real no knowledge of how farming and food is produced, but certainly he's recognised as a leading authority within the industry.
In championing British agriculture within the House of Lords, Henry though has never taken his eye off the future of the industry. He has created the Henry Plum Foundation.
The Henry Plum Foundation is a fantastic opportunity for young people to progress within the industry. Henry wanted to put the foundation together to really help young people, to give them a leg up to help make a difference within agriculture.
He's a great team builder, and whenever he sets out with an organisation, he will build around him a team of people who he encourages and who he stimulates to work together.
He was fantastic at being there as an ambassador for the organisation and truly encouraging young people to fulfil their potential.
It's just a no-brainer. Henry is the outstanding character of British agriculture. We owe him a massive thanks for leading the industry, for being the father of British agriculture over a remarkable 76 years. Well done, Henry. Thank you very much.